Money, money at 7 o'clock. 98.7 WFGR, the powerhouse of Town Square Media, Dave.
Yes.
And we're swinging the bat today, buddy.
Yeah, we're swinging from both sides of
the
plate.
We're swinging from both sides. We have got it going on. In fact, you know who just walked in and sat down?
No.
The mayor.
No way.
Yes, sir.
You know,
George Hartwell.
We're not big enough for the mayor yet. This is day two.
What are you talking about? Of course.
He's right there.
This is it. This is what's happening in Grand Rapids.
Good morning, Mr. Mayor.
Well, welcome, guys.
Nice to see you. How are you today?
Great. Just great.
You know, Dave is on his way here soon. He's out at TV 13 because he's kind of a big deal being on the television.
He's He's the one that's got the face for TV.
Yeah.
Right?
Look at me.
Well, I can see. I can see.
At least he's honest.
We won't describe it. But
Mayor pulling no punches today.
Perfect. Oh man.
So welcome.
Well, thank you.
Thank you for getting up and coming in. Is this how your day starts off?
This is great. What better way to start the day?
Yeah, I'm sure.
You know, it's a beautiful morning. There were stars out when I walked.
It's beautiful, isn't it? So here's the thing. I started off in radio 23 years ago, 1989. I worked here for 12 years in Grand Rapids. I've been out in Muskegon for the last 12.
You did a NASCAR gig, didn't you?
I got a NASCAR job, too.
Oh, my gosh.
Still hanging on to that.
Oh, are you really? Well, just in case this doesn't work out.
Well, you know what? If we get a weekend or something, here comes the general manager. He wants in, too.
I hope it's going to work out, Andy. That's the plan. That's why you're here.
No, the NASCAR thing, you know, it was kind of one of these deals where we worked it out. So if I do have to be at a race on a weekend, get on a plane after I get out of here, and off we go.
Well, that's great.
It's fun.
That's great.
It's a good thing to do, and it's a lot of good experience and things like that.
Yeah. Do you drive?
I've driven.
Yeah?
I haven't driven in the NASCAR level, but I've driven on NASCAR tracks five or six times.
Wow,
it's fun.
Wow, yeah.
We'll take you down there sometime.
Yeah, great, great.
Well, the mayor only rides a bike, though.
That's right.
I don't know. I think we could find him a stock car.
What's your carbon footprint for that car?
It's small. You know, 4 or 5 miles to a gallon. Leaded fuel. We don't have much of a carbon footprint.
What do you mean? Right. 4 or 5 gallons to a mile.
That's right. We move it. So let's just say I've been out of town, completely gone for the last 12 years, and I have not seen the massive, incredible explosion that Grand Rapids has gone through.
Wow. It's kind of like a Rip Van Winkle coming back.
Huh? Isn't it something?
It is amazing what's happened in Grand Rapids in the last decade.
When I come down here now, I think back to those years because, you know, when I was a kid, I used to park out behind where the Van Andel Arena is now. I watched them dig the hole. I watched the whole thing. And to see that whole area of Grand Rapids come back to life.
Oh, yeah. It's fabulous. Just fantastic.
I wouldn't have walked down Ionia Avenue without packing heat back when I was a kid. You couldn't. It was scary.
Well, I worked there.
Yeah.
So
And now it's just...
Yeah.
It's alive.
Yeah, it is. You know, the whole city has just come alive.
And,
you know, for me, the exciting thing is that we're attracting and we're retaining, we're holding young talent, bright young kids that are coming to college here, and then they're staying after they graduate, or maybe they go off to college someplace else, and they live in Chicago for a couple of years, and they find that Grand Rapids is a pretty cool place to be.
It's
and
a
they
great
come
place
back.
To be.
Yeah. They come back.
Great place to raise a family. Great place to...
you could raise chitlins, too.
Chitlins?
Childrens.
I said chitlins.
Yeah, I know you did. That's the kind of top comedy we deal with Dave, Mr. Mayor. Sorry about that. He also manages to screw up 2 or 3 times a day, too, which is what the bell's for. We'll keep that in reserve. So, overall, you're not running for election this year, are you?
I am not.
You're not.
Oh, my gosh. I'm sure glad I'm not running this year. What a mess out there, isn't it?
Isn't it something?
You know, it's just the ugliest election campaign I've seen in a long time.
And you've never done that. You've never had any kind of...
Well, no. I mean, we don't have to, I guess, maybe at the local level so much. We're pretty civil around here.
Yeah. Let me ask you this, and I'm only asking because coming from Muskegon, where I've been for the last 12 years, is your job a full-time job as opposed to the mayor of Muskegon, who's kind of, I don't necessarily want to say part-time, but he maintains another job and does something else too.
Yeah, it's a great question. It is compensated as a part-time job.
Yep. So is this. Now that you point that out, we got something coming.
Whoops, Russ, let's talk about this, shall we?
Let's see here.
Okay, this is a great time to negotiate. I'll be your
Hear
I'll
that?
Be your negotiator.
You
your
hear
agent.
That, Dave?
I'm
we got the agent. We got our agent. Perfect.
Okay,
that's a good thing, George.
So I can ask for a raise now?
Too bad, Andy.
You know, mayors in Grand Rapids since 1916 have been, when the charter was adopted, have been considered part-time employees.
Is that
the
right?
City. So up until just a little over a week ago, I had a second job as the CEO of a retirement corporation.
Is that right?
Pilgrim Manor Retirement Company.
Oh, I know that place.
You know Pilgrim
sure.
Manor? Yeah, well, I just retired from there.
Nice.
So I'm sort of feeling my way into the mayor as a full-time job on part-time pay.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Well, that's kind of good. I mean,
well,
I think
so, too. I'm of an age where I can do that. I can afford to do that, and it's I love the city. I love the work.
Isn't that great?
It's a very cool time to be mayor of Grand Rapids.
What about grandkids and all that kind of stuff? You got a bunch of them?
I do. Susan and I have three children and six grandchildren, two of them out in L.A. and four of them right here in Grand Rapids.
That's good, aren't they? Yeah. I got a wife, right?
Yeah.
Believe it or not, I found a girl that would marry me. We've got three kids and now five grandkids.
Oh, you got five grandkids?
Yeah.
Do you really?
Married a cougar.
You look much too young.
I married a cougar. Thank you. I jumped right on that bandwagon and said, this is for me. Let's find an older girl. She's great. But grandkids are fun.
Aren't they? Are they all around here?
We got two out in Seattle.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we miss them a lot. But overall, the rest of them are right here. And it's funny how usually 5:30, 6 o'clock on a Friday or Saturday, there's a knock at the door.
Mm-hmm.
And you just know that there's a diaper bag and some kid getting dropped off. So you can spend your Friday night the way you wanted to.
Oh, exactly.
As opposed
to
the kid.
Well, those are memories now.
Yeah.
Our youngest is 9.
Is that
so
right?
They range from 9 to 17.
Wow. That's cool. Yeah. What are some of the things you think are pressing around town? What are some of the issues that are concerning you right now?
Well, I think from a municipal perspective, the challenge of budget deficits, which has been a perpetual problem, it seems like, for the last decade. But it's having enough money to keep the streets in their current pristine condition. There's not a pothole in a street in Grand Rapids, as we all know very well, and so keeping them that way is real important. From the city's perspective, it's matching our jobs to the growth that we're experiencing.
Right.
In other words, the biggest complaint I'm hearing right now from employers is the pool isn't big enough.
Right.
We need more skilled people here in Grand Rapids, whether it's in manufacturing or in banking. We need more skilled people in Grand Rapids. So everything the city is doing right now,
yep,
in terms of creating an environment that's exciting, that's dynamic, that is environmentally sensitive, all of that is really, really important, I think, to attracting and retaining those bright young people.
And again, it gets back to the growth I've seen over the last dozen years, 12, 15 years, something like that. When you come back down, when I was, you know, like I said, when I was down here as a kid, you could have shot a cannon and not hit anybody. And now we've got a really vibrant community.
We do. We do.
It's amazing to
anybody who's been down in the last 2.5 weeks knows that this something's cooking in Grand Rapids.
But they give you like a motorcade and all that stuff.
Oh, of course,
right?
Of course.
So you don't
big security. My security's right outside here. Be careful.
Really?
The Pope Mobile.
The Pope Mobile.
Well, I'll tell you what. You've got, I would imagine, a pretty busy day coming up.
Got a good day coming up. It's a City Commission Day. Committee of the Whole meets first thing this morning. So,
and do you realize that I'm a mayor as well?
I did not know that.
I'm the mayor of Facebook.
Well, congratulations.
Somebody had to jump in there and take control of that carnival, and it was me.
Well, so I'm glad that you were willing to sacrifice.
I do that for the people.
And the pay on that is
huge, comparable to mine. Oh, yeah. There's always people popping up on Facebook going, come on over and we'll give you free dinner. We'd like to give you an airplane ticket. You know.
Yeah, okay.
The perks. The jobs.
The perks.
Although, you know, honestly, I am a city council member.
Are you?
Yeah. I'm a Roosevelt Park Planning Commissioner.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, congratulations.
So we got a little thing going on there.
Great.
And
that's
dipping
great.
My toe in that. And
Roosevelt Park has come through this recession fairly well, hasn't
it? It's not bad. It's really not a bad little community. And,
yeah,
you know, lucky for me, with my limited abilities, Roosevelt Park is a one-square-mile city.
Yeah.
There ain't a lot to worry about. there's not a whole lot of pressing issues, and there's not a whole lot of.
Well, as soon as that planning commission gig is finished, and yep. there must be terms to
three-year term.
I expect you to move to Grand Rapids.
There you have it. See that, Dave?
No, I missed that.
No, oh, okay. Why would you pay attention?
Well,
exactly.
I can't actually hear anything on my end.
Oh, you can't hear the mayor?
No.
Oh, well,
I've been
good.
Faking my way through
who
this.
Who are you talking
Thanks
to,
for
man?
Blowing
Dave,
it.
Dave Cackley's on the other.
Who are you talking? I can't hear in a voice.
I know.
Can
yeah.
you hear a voice?
Now I can.
Now he's
now I hear the mayor.
He's a television star,
Very
Mr.
dulcet
mayor.
Tones coming from the mayor.
Now, one final thing, and we're going to hold you to this. Now, in Muskegon, Steve Warmington declared Andy and Dave Day.
Oh.
Now, I'd like you to thumb through your calendar, maybe go through your Rolodex or whatever you got to do. We should have an Andy and Dave day here, too.
Or at least 12 hours.
Andy.
We can't get a full day. We should get 12 hours.
That's fair. You know, what we could do is get the date named. We could have him name the date, and then you and I could get to work on putting something on for the people of GR. Maybe
That's
next
a good
summer.
Idea.
What a cool idea.
Yeah.
What a cool idea.
I'm all for
You'll
it.
Throw a big party.
We'll throw a party.
We'll call it
Andy and Dave Day. Yeah,
Or Dave and Andy Day.
It's Andy and Dave Day.
Andy and Dave.
You know, I'm on TV, so my name should be first.
You see what I'm working with here?
Yeah, yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
Us guys and Dave, right. us guys well, in high political jobs, we understand, you know, the ankle biters like
right.
you. So we let it slide off our...
Don't forget my kickback.
That's right, your kickback. City Council meeting today. Good luck out there, Mr. Mayor.
Thanks so much for having me on. Welcome to the station.
And
it's great to have you guys here.
The door is open.
Thanks.
I'm here to tell you, if you got something you want to come in and talk about, free reign.
All right. You got it.
There he is, everybody. Mayor George Hartwell. Back into some music here. What am I? There we go. All right. 7-Eleven. It's Frankenstein. Edgar Winter. It is on 98.7 WFGR.